Hi everyone, I am Golda Brunner, currently serving as Assistant Professor in Government College of Engineering, Salem. In this session, let's discuss about insertion sort. Any sorting algorithm will take a sequence of items as input. For example, 3, 1, 7, 5, 2, 4. When we have similar items, from our prior knowledge of programming, we can conclude that I can use an array to store these elements. So let's use an array A to store all these 6 numbers so that I can use the index to refer to the individual items. So A of 1 will refer to the first element, which is 3, and A of 6 will refer to the last item, which is 4. The sorting algorithm will take this array as input and produces as output a permutation such that A of 1 is less than or equal to A of 2, which is less than or equal to A of 3, and so on till A of n. That means that the first element is less than or equal to the second element, which is less than or equal to the third element, and so on till the last element. So for our example, the sorted output will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 7. Coming to the insertion sort, it is a very practical sorting algorithm, very similar to our playing cards. So I have, for the sake of simplicity, I have taken only the diamonds and the cards which are numbered. So so we'll shuffle the card and then we'll have it on the, have it as a pile. So when we take the first card, which is 5, we don't have to sort this. It is just one element and it is already sorted. When I take the second card, which is 9, I compare it with 5, and then I find that 9 is greater than 5, so I just put it to the right of 5. When I take the next card, which is 3, I compare it with 9. So 3 is less than 9, I shift 9 one position right, and then I go and compare it with 5. Again 3 is less than 5, so I shift it one position right, and then I know this is the right position to insert 3. So similarly, so the cards that I hold on my left hand are already sorted. The cards which are on the pile are unsorted. So the array, the input array, will be considered as the concatenation of the cards in the left hand and the cards on the pile. So one portion of the array will be sorted, the other portion of the array we keep sorting. So when we compare the element, okay, say for example, I'll take another card, I can either come from the left card or I can compare, keep comparing them from the right card. Which way is better? When we do it manually, either way is fine. But when we do it in a computer, when I do it from left to right, suppose if I compare 3 and 6, I know that this is not the right position to insert 6, and when I compare 6 and 5, I know that I haven't come to the right position. Then when I come here, I know that this is the position where I have to insert 6. So if I insert it like this, okay, in a system, it is more like overriding the already existing element, which is 9. Rather, if we consider taking the card in my right hand side from the pile as saving the variable in another variable, saving the value in another variable. When I compare this 6 and 9, I can shift this 9 one position right, which is the position where originally the 6 was, which will not be lost because I have taken this and copied to another variable. So I can just shift it right, and then I can go and compare 6 against 5. Now I know that 6 is greater than 5, then I know that this is the right position, so I can just insert back to the array. So I get the sorted items. So this is how the insertion sort works. So I repeat, when we take the first card, it is already sorted. I take the second card, I make the comparison from right to left. So I compare with 9 and I find 9 is greater. So I just shift one position right, the 9, and then just insert 6. And then I take the other. When I take it in the right hand, it is more like copying this value to another variable. And then I just compare 5 with 9. 9 is greater, so I just shift one position right, and then I go and compare 5 with 6. I know 6 is greater, so I shift one position right. Then I know that this is the right position I have to insert. See here how long we keep comparing. Shift I till I reach the left end of the array. So I have to go till the left end of the array, or I find the right position of the element in the array. So let's see this using an example. The first row is an input, the entire unsorted elements. The next row will indicate the first element 3 in red color. So I mean to say that it is already sorted. So I just take the second element to be the element to be inserted, and I store it in the variable key. Then I compare the key against the first element of the array, which is 3. And I know that 1 is less than 3. So I have to shift 3 to the right and then insert key to the first position of A. So these operations are indicated with the labels small a, b, c and d. So A is actually taking out or copying the element to the variable key, and then we compare B is actually, the B is representing the operation of comparing the key with the first element of A. Since 3 is greater than the key, we move 3 to its right position, one position right, where originally 1 was residing. And then we copy 1 back to the array. So when we finish this, we find that 1 and 3 are now sorted. So we move to the next value, which is 7. We copy this into key and then compare 7 and 3, and we find that 7 is greater. So we insert back 7 in the same position. And when we take 5, the next element which has to be sorted. So I copy 5 to key and then I compare 5 against 7. I find that 7 is greater. So I move 7 one position right, and then I go and compare 5 with 3. Now I find that 5 is greater. So I know that this is the place I have to insert 5. So I just insert 5. So at the end of this iteration, I'll get 1, 3, 5, 7 sorted. In the next item, 2, which has to be sorted, we have to keep comparing 2 against 7, and we find that 7 is greater, so we move one position right. Then 2 against 5, we move 5 to one position right, and then we compare 2 against 3. 3 is greater, so we move one position right. And then finally, when I compare 2 against 1, I know that 1 is less. So I have to insert 2 in the place where 3 was originally residing. Okay, similarly, I can do so. So when I finish, we find that all the elements are sorted. So to recap, I start from the second element of the array. Okay, and keep comparing with the sorted portion of the array. The first element of the array to start with is sorted. And when I finish one iteration, I know that one element is getting sorted. So that the left portion of the array is getting sorted and the unsorted elements are available in the right side. And as and when we move right, we keep the array sorted, and finally we will have the entire array sorted. So the key element, we are starting from the second position and keep moving till the last element of the array. Now what you can do is you can pause this video for 10 minutes and write the pseudocode on your own for the operation that we have discussed, which is insertion sort. Then you can resume this video and check whether you have written it correctly. Now the insertion sort, let's write the pseudocode. A is the input and we are writing a function which is the insertion sort, and A is the input which is an array. Now we have to, every time I take the key out and keep comparing with the elements in the left and left of the key in the array. So the key we started taking from the second element and till the last element we repeatedly did that. So we need to have a for loop, because I know exactly I have to start from the second position of the array and go till the end of the array. So we'll use a for loop for j is equal to 2 to length of a. Then I am taking the jth element out as the key. Now we have to compare this key against all the, not all the elements, elements which are greater than the key I have to compare, and keep moving them right. If the key is less than the element available in the array to the left of key, then I have to keep the elements in the array to move right. So we do not know how many comparisons we need to make in this. So the better choice would be to go for a while loop. So what is the first element I have to compare? I have to compare the element which is immediately before the key. Okay, so the key is at the jth position. So we'll use another variable I, which is j minus 1. And how long I, maybe the worst case I have to go till the beginning of the array. So we have to make an additional condition, which is while I greater than 0 and A of I is greater than key. If this is the case, then I have to move A of I to A of I plus 1. So A of I plus 1 is equal to I, and then we decrement I so that I move to the previous element we have currently compared. So how do we know that this pseudocode is correct? Let's check the correctness of the algorithm.